So when I say God loves you, you all will respond, God loves you too. So let's try that. God loves you.
God loves you too.
Now, I've been doing these origami figures to think of the various things that are going on to the ark, right? That first covenant that we've been thinking about, Noah and the ark, is a continuous thing. Now, this time, I made a little snake here, but unfortunately it kind of pops out and almost looks more like a green dove, I think. So I felt a little self-conscious about that. But this is this week's origami figure, a little snake, right? But just because I wanted to make sure you got the image there. So here's a little bigger snake that we can kind of look at and see. And on one hand, there's kind of two things I want us to think about. One of them is just that as we think of the various animals that go onto the ark two by two, one set are snakes. Even though snakes are kind of scary, they, they're not really something that most of us, you know, think of as warm, fuzzy creatures that we'd really want to sort of repopulate the earth. And yet even them, they also go onto the ark and are saved from the waters of the flood. They're part of that covenant that God makes, not just with Noah, but with the whole earth, including even snakes. So just to think about that, but also in today's gospel lesson, we read about snakes. And that there's this strange image of a snake that Moses puts up to make it so people don't get sick and die even when they're bitten by this snake. And it's a really strange story. And I just want to acknowledge that it's a strange story. And yet in John's gospel, John picks up that image and says, you know, just as these Israelites are able to live even when they're bitten, right? Oh my. So too, you know, that Jesus, when we look upon Jesus, when we look up, when we have trust, when we have faith in Jesus Christ, that we too are avoiding this bite of death, that there's a way in which God has provided for us a way of life as well. So please know that there's a way of life for you, and whenever it feels like things are maybe a little too much and getting a little scary, just look up, have faith, trust that God has got you, that God loves you so deeply and is committed to you always. Let us pray. Lord God, thank you for the love you show us in so many ways. Thank you that we are able to look upon your Son, Jesus, that we are able to trust him, and that you have provided for us eternal life. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.